Hi friends, this is Sarvajit here. Welcome to my networking channel. Hope all are doing good. And today let us discuss and debug the authentication issue about PPP. So PPP is one of the WAN protocol which works at the data link layer, right? So in PPP, especially in a data link layer, there are two protocols for PPP. One is LCP, that is for establishing the link, and another one is NCP, network control protocol. So PPP authentication mechanism, there are two types of authentication. One is PAP and CHAP. So PAP, right, in passwords are sent in clear text. So today in this architecture, due to some authentication issues, so from PC1, I am not able to reach PC2. So PC1 IP is 172.16.10.2 and PC2, the IP is 172.16.20.2. So this both the IPs I am not able to reach, and this serial interface I have assigned 1.1 and 1.2. So this serial interface I have assigned the IP 1.1 and 1.2, right? So let us see the serial interface are up. And then let us see the authentication messages. What is the message you are getting from the both R1 and R2, right? So that's the thing I'm going to discuss now. So let us go to R1 and let us check the authentication flow. So I enabled the debug PPP authentication. So that is the debug command we have to enable for both PPP authentication, CHAP and PAP. So right, so we are seeing some error. Send PAP login request. You are able to see send PAP login request, and the login response is fake. So because of that reason, what happened? I'm not able to reach from PC1 to PC2. So PC1 I'm pinging, PC2 host IP, we are seeing the destination unreachable. And from PC2 also I'm pinging 10.2, I'm receiving the destination unreachable. That means PC1 and PC2 are not reachable because of this authentication issues that exist between R1 and R2. So how to fix the issue? Let us go to R1 first and let us check it out. So let us remove the debug, and in case of PAP, you should know how to configure the PAP, right? First of all, so then it is easy for us to troubleshoot the PAP authentication. Go to R1, let us go to R2, show run include username. So first thing you have to always configure the username. So the username should be username the same R1, same host name you have to use, username R1, password hello. So in case of R2, you have to give same way, show run include username. So in case of R2, you have to give the same thing, right? So let us remove the debug. R2 username should be same thing. R2 username, host name is R2, password hello. So this is the case of PAP authentication. In case of CHAP, we'll give a reverse way, username, host name of R2, right? So in case of PAP, we will give the same name. Username should be R1 and the password should be hello. Same for R2, username should be R2, that is a host name for R2, password should be hello. So but these passwords would remain same on both R1 and R2. So what are the other things we need to do is, I'm going to show you. Show run interface serial 6/0. So this is a command I have to configure for PAP. One is encapsulation PPP. So PPP authentication mechanism, we are using for PAP. That's the reason I have to configure PAP. Then we have to configure PPP PAP sent username R1 password hello. So this is here there is a conflict. So here what we have to do, always I have to send username R1 is nothing but you have to always use the R2, that is a remote host name password, right? So you have to use remote R2. So similar way in R2 also you have to use the same thing, show run. So I have different way. PPP PAP sent username should be not R2, R1. So that is the reason it is not for authenticating. So let us now go ahead and remove it. So go to interface serial 6/0. So there are two benefits. First thing, you can understand how to configure. Second thing, once you understand the configuration, you can easily troubleshoot and debug, right? So PPP now PAP sent username should be R2, right? So then password hello. So we have fixed the R1 issue. So now let us go to R2. So go to the configuration mode. What does the interface of R2 is? Serial 4/0, right? So interface serial 4/0. No, let us remove it, right? Let us remove it. Then you have to configure PPP PAP sent username should be R1. That is host name of R1. Password should remain the same on both R1 and R2. So now I are done with the configuration. So now you are able to see, right? Immediately I'm seeing the serial interfaces are coming up. That means the configuration is working fine. So if you want, let us now do one thing. Go to the configuration mode interface serial 6/0. And let us remove it again. Encapsulation PPP and no PPP authentication tab, right? So what we can do, let us going to do that again. Show run so that I want to see the message flow. Serial 6 by 0, right? So what we can do, let us debug the PPP authentication. PPP authentication. So let after debugging, then we'll configure it again so that you can see the flows. So encapsulation PPP, then PPP. See, after removing, you are seeing the serial interface going down, right? Authentication is tab, then PPP tab. Sent username should be R2, then password should remain the same. Hello. So now you can see the serial interface are coming up both R1 and R2, right? And so now you can see the authentication flows. You are seeing the right send PAP login request, receive login response is pass. That means it is using hostname and password for PAP. So now we are receiving the authentication as PAP login, right? PAP login request, and we are getting the response as pass. That means we are able to communicate between R1 and R2. So now let us check in host, right? We are able to receive from host 1 to host 2. So let us ping from PC1 to PC2 IP. So still I am not able to reach. Let us see PC2 and let us check from PC2. So still it is showing destination unreachable. So I think it is taking some time. Let us see. Show IP load. So if we want, we can clear the PPP statistics. And let us go to R2 and let us clear the PPP statistics. So now let us check the directly connected interfaces ping 172.16.10.1. So I'm able to ping the directly gateway, the same gateway I'm able to ping. Now let us check the remote PC 20.2, right? Still I'm not able to reach, so there should be an issue. So we need to fix that issue. 172.16.20.2. I'm not able to reach 20.2. So that might be a static routing issue. We need to fill it. Let us fix the static routing. So we have to create a static route for reaching the subnet. And PC2, we have to create a static route. So we need to check that static route does exist. Show run include route. So that might be missing. That is one of the troubleshooting we can do, right? Go to configuration mode, IP route. So what is the thing we need to do is we have to create a static route 172.16.20.0. 255.255.255.0. Then we have to create this interface. This is a gateway, right? So 192.168.1.1. So sorry, it is 1.2. Configuration mode and it is 1.2, right? So that's an extra interface. And similar way, let us go to R2 and let us fix it out. Go to the configuration mode and IP route. 172.16.10.0. That is a remote subnet 10.0 followed with 255.255.255.0. Then we have to create 192.168.1.1. So I have created a static route. Now let us ping the interfaces. So now I'm able to reach it, right? From PC1 to PC2, I'm able to reach. And PC2, let us reach from PC1, I'm able to reach, right? So in case of any mismatch issue, right? In case of any mismatch, so if you want, we can create a mismatch in the authentication again and let us check it out. So go to serial and 4 by 0, sorry, 6 by 0, and let us interface serial 6 by 0. Then I'm doing no PPP. So in this case also what happened, there will be authentication mismatch because I'm not doing anything. So if I'm doing some wrong authentication also, you can't reach the host. PPP PAP sent username I'm giving R1 and the host password I'm giving hello. See, there is also totaling, it is a combination that is valid for CHAP, then that is a security hole. That means there is an issue is coming. So now let us do one thing. Interface serial 6 by 0, no encapsulation PPP, no PPP, authentication. So this will remove the entire thing. Let us catch it again. Show run interface serial 6 by 0. So go to interface serial 6 by 0 encapsulation PPP. PPP authentication is PAP, right? Authentication is PAP, then PAP PPP PAP username is sent. Username should be R2. If I'm giving R1, then we'll see the issue. R1, then password we'll see it as hello. So immediately you'll see authentication is failed, right? So now you can see the PC1 from to PC2. We can't reach the PC2. So you're seeing the destination unreachable. You are able to see that destination is unreachable. Similar way from PC2 also destination is unreachable. So that is the reason always you have to check for the authentication issue. So how to do a debug? Go to configuration mode, show run interface serial 6 by 0. So go to configuration interface serial 6 by 0. No PPP authentication PAP and no encapsulation PPP. So let us remove it first, then we let us now it will entirely remove the configuration. So now let us configure it again. So interface serial 6 by 0. So encapsulation is PPP, PPP authentication is PAP. Then we'll configure the PAP. PAP sent username, sorry, it is PPP PAP. Sent username is R2, so it is R2, and the password should be what we configured is hello, right? So now you can see the authentication flows. So now you can see it is coming up, right? Both the serial interface are coming up. Now let us ping from PC1 to PC2. So now you are able to reach from PC1 to PC2, and from PC2 I am able to reach PC1. So this is the way you have to go and troubleshoot the issue. So I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. Thanks and have a wonderful day.